Hello everyone, now we have to discuss problems on network theorems. So we have plenty of problems from this network theorems from GATE, ESC, SSC, JEE and other public sector units. But I am not solving each and every problem. Only some of the problems I am going to solve here, but remaining n number of problems from these theorems you have to solve by yourself. We have plenty of objective books in the market. Electrical engineering objective. Just go and buy any one of the publication and solve the n number of problems. For the subjects, you have to solve n number of problems only. Then only you will get the confidence about the subject, right? This is the first problem. This is GATE 1998. Viewed from terminals A and B, the following circuit shown in figure can be reduced to an equivalent circuit, means this is the application of Millman's theorem, right, to a single voltage source in series with a single resistor with the following parameters. So, these are the options. This is the problem of Millman's theorem. We all know that V equivalent is nothing but what? Plus or minus V into simple V by R 1 plus or minus V 2 by R 2. How many sources we have? Only 2, that is it. By 1 by R 1 plus 1 by R 2, that is it. From this V equivalent is equals to what? Plus, that is it. Plus 10 by, what is the value of R 1? 6 plus 5 by 4, right? By 1 by 6 plus 1 by 4, that is it. From this, V equivalent is equals to 12, that is 20 plus 3, 15, 35. Here we have 2 plus 3, 5. Therefore, V equivalent is equals to 7 volts. So, 7 volts. Next, R equivalent, which is equals to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2, right? Therefore, R equivalent is equals to 1 by 6 plus 1 by 4, which is equals to 5 by 12. Therefore, R equivalent is equals to 12 by 5, which is equals to 2.4 ohms. That's it. Option B is correct. 7 volts in series with, that is, this is A, this is B, this is 7, this is 2.4, that is it. This is the Millman's equation, or you can solve this problem by using Thevenin's method or Norton's method, right. Next, second problem. In the circuit shown below, the maximum power transferred to R. So, let us say this is A and B. So, we have to calculate the maximum power transferred to R. This is the load for us, right. So, what is the condition to get maximum power? This R should be RTH, and what is the value of P max? VTH square by 4 RTH, that is it. Then first we have to calculate RTH, then we have to calculate P max, right. To calculate RTH. Short circuited, only we have this branch, this is open, right, this is also short circuited, this is 5, this is open, right, circuit is like this. Short circuited. So, this is A, this is B. We have to calculate R T H between these two, right? Between these two, we have to calculate R T H. What is the value here? 5. So, this is short circuited, means what? There is no use of this, right? What is the value of this resistance? r equals to 0, here we have some value of resistance 0 into something by 0 plus something, we will get 0, right? Short circuited. Therefore, we will get, this is A, this is 5 ohm branch, like this. From this only we have again one branch, that's it, 5. This is B, that's it. Therefore, RTH is equals to what? 5 into 5 by 10, which is equals to 2.5. RTH equals to 2.5, that's it, clear. Next, VTH, R value should be equals to, that is R is equals to 2.5 ohms. Next, we have to calculate VTH, right? VTH means plus minus minus plus we have current source. This is 2, this is 5, what is the value? This is 3, this is 6, this is 5, this is 5. See, this is A, this is B, right? Between these two we have to calculate RTH, VOC, plus minus, clear. Then, see, this is C, this is A, right? This is what? Supernode, right? Supernode, that is this voltage minus this drop is equals to, that is VC minus VA, which is equals to 6. That is VC minus VA is nothing but VTH, right? Which is equals to 6. Clear. Then we have to remove that branch. Therefore, the circuit becomes plus minus two, five, 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 right? This is VC, this is VOC. Right, that is nothing but VTH. Clear. From this, VOC minus 5 by 5 plus VOC, clear. This is VC by 5, this is also leaving, which is equals to 2, 0. Clear? Means this is supernode. That's it. So, from this, VC is equals to what? 6 plus VOC, right? 6 plus, and substitute this VC value into here. That is VTH minus 5 plus VC, 6 plus VOC, and that is 6 plus VTH by 5. So, from this we got two VTH plus 1 plus 10, two VTH plus 1 plus 10 means 11, which is equals to 0. Therefore, VTH is equals to minus 5.5. This is the value of VTH and this is the value of RTH. Therefore, P max, which is equals to what? VTH square by 4 RTH. Therefore, P max, which is equals to, what is the value of VTH? Minus 5.5 whole square by 4 into 2.5. This is 10, right? Therefore, 3.025 watts. The answer is 3.025 watts. This is the answer. For the circuit shown in figure, when the voltage is 10 volts and the current I is 1 ampere, this is 10, excitation is 10, response is 1 ampere. If the applied voltage across the terminal CD is 100 volts, then the short circuit current flowing through the terminals A and B is what? So, this is the application of reciprocity theorem. See, first case the excitation is what? 10, at that case the response is 1 ampere. Then later we have interchanged the excitation between C and D. Then what is the current through between this A and B? So, what is the statement of reciprocity theorem? What we have the interchanges, that is with respect to the interchanges, the ratio of the response to the excitation should be same from first case to second case. Okay, first E1, that is by reciprocity theorem, means what? The circuit is, this is network 1, this is, and this is the current, right? This is E1, this is I1. Next we have network 2, this is E2 plus minus, then what is the value of short circuit current through this? I2 is, well, this is what, 10 volts, at this case 1 ampere, now this is 100 volts, what is the value of I2? Means principle of homogeneity, here excitation is scaled by 10 times, right? That is 100 equals to 10 into 10. Obviously, the current should be scaled by 10 times, that is 1 into 10, 10 amps. Therefore, current would scaled by 10 times also, that is ISC between what? A and B, capital A and B, is equals to 10 amperes. Or by reciprocity theorem, what is the response to the excitation, which is equals to response to the excitation in the second case, that is I1 is what? 1 by 10, which is equals to I2, we do not know, by 100. From this I2 is equals to 10 amperes. So, by inspection only we can get the answer, there is no need of solving. By inspection, see, E1 is 10, E2 is what? 100, it is scaled by 10 times, obviously the current should be scaled by 10 times, then the answer is 10 amperes. The resistance seen from the terminals A and B of the device whose characteristic is shown in figure. Okay, this is the characteristic, from this characteristic we have to calculate the resistance between these two terminals, means that is RTH, right? Okay. From the characteristics, if you consider 0, this is nothing but this is what? Minus 4, 0. Then means 0, 20 means what? Current is 0. Then this is nothing but VOC. Here ISC is nothing but minus 4, voltage is 0, means what? Short circuited. This is minus 4 is nothing but ISC. Here current is 0, open circuited. This V is nothing but VOC. VOC by ISC, we got ISC, that is, see the current direction, it is reverse. From characteristics, simple. 0, 20 means what? This is 20 is nothing but what? I is equals to 0. Therefore, this is what? VOC, right? From this, VOC is nothing but 20. Clear? Like that, from minus 4 comma 0, this is what ISC, this is what V is equals to 0, then this is ISC. From this, ISC is equals to minus 4 amps, ISC is equals to minus 4. But see, the current direction is opposite into the network, that is why you should consider ISC is equals to 4. Opposite to I, opposite to I, since opposite to I, okay. Therefore, ISC is what? 4. Therefore, RTH is equals to VOC by ISC, which is equals to 20 by 4. Therefore, 5 ohms is the correct answer. Option D is correct. This is method 1. So, like this you have to solve, or if you have any confusion, then go through this method, that is method 2. So, we have what? Minus 4 comma 0 and 0 comma 20. Now, we have to get the equation of a straight line, right? So, this is the current, this is the voltage, this is the current, this is the voltage, right? Therefore, voltage V minus 0, which is equals to 20 minus 0 by 0 plus 4 by what is current minus, right? So, V is equals to 5 into I plus 4, that is it. Therefore, V is equals to 5I plus 20. We have to get the value of resistance, right? So, from this, dV is equals to 5dI. Therefore, dV by dI is nothing but 5. This is nothing but RTH, right? Answer is over. So, like this also you will get the answer from this method, or from this method you will get the answer. The answer is 5 ohms. Next problem is, the black box as shown in figure contains resistors and independent sources. Then for R is equals to 0, the value of I is 3, and for R is equals to 2, the value of I is 1.5 respectively. The value of I for R is equals to 1 will be what? This is the problem from ESC 2003. Okay, these are the options. For R is equals to 0, I should be is equals to what? 3 amps. R is equals to 0 means what? Short circuit, right? Therefore, this current is nothing but ISC. ISC is nothing but 3 amperes. This model is very important model. Very important model. So, R is equals to 0 means what? Short circuited. Therefore, this current is nothing but short circuited current. That is VTH by RTH is equals to 3. That is the meaning, right? ISC is nothing but 3 amps means what? VTH by RTH is nothing but 3. This is case 1. Case 1. Okay. Like that, case 2. If R is equals to 0, that is for R equals to 2, I is equals to what? 3 by 2, that is 1.5 amps. That is VTH by RTH is nothing but, sorry, this is not short circuit current. If we consider Thevenin circuit, RTH plus R, right, which is equals to 3 by 2. From this, right? So, R is nothing but 2. So, VTH by RTH, we do not know, plus what is the value of R2, which is equals to 1.5. So this is 2. So from 1 and 2, from 1 and 2, VTH equals 3RTH, that is 3RTH by RTH plus 2, which is equals to 3 by 2. From this, 3 gets cancelled, therefore 2RTH plus RTH is equals to RTH plus 2, therefore RTH is equals to 2 ohms, that's it. So we have RTH, therefore I is equals to what? VTH by RTH plus R, right? I is equals to, what is the value of VTH? So from this, VTH is equals to what? 3 into RTH, right? Which is equals to 6 volts. 6, therefore 6 by 2 plus required is what? We have to calculate the current for R is equals to 1, therefore 6 by 3, therefore I is equals to 2 amps. The answer is 2. This model is very important model. So he provided 2 cases. So with respect to the 2 cases, we will get the relation. After getting the relation, we have to substitute the relations into this case 3, right? That is case, from case 3 we will get the answer. You can tell the answer by inspection also. See, he provided R is equals to 0, I is equals to 3, that is R is equals to 0, I is equals to 3, like that R is equals to 2, I is equals to what? 1.5, but he wants the current, when R is equals to 1, obviously the answer should be in between 1.5 and 3. Next problem is, consider the circuits A and B, this is the circuit A, this is the circuit B, and we have the terminals A and B, right? For what values of I and R, the circuit B is equivalent to A, means nothing but we have to get this equivalent circuit. Means what? This is looks like what? Not equivalent circuit of Norton's, Norton's theorem, equivalent circuit, current source in parallel with the resistance, that's it. First we have to get what? RTH, RN, right? RN, Norton's current. So short those resistances, simple. This is A, this is B, this is 40 ohms, this is 60 ohms, that's it. Between these two we have to calculate RN. Therefore RN is what? 40 into 60 by 100. 24 volts, that's it. With 24 only one option, that is option B. Simple, but we have to calculate ISC R IN. Next, ISC. Plus minus. Again we have a branch, this is plus minus, this is given as 120, this is 60, this is 60, this is 40, this is A, this is B, short circuited. We have to calculate ISC, right? Therefore V minus 120 by 40, which is equals to dB plus V minus 60 by, that's it. From this 3V minus plus 2b minus 120 is equals to 0. 5b is equals to e is equals to what? 96 volts, right? V is equals to 96. This is what? Sorry. This is VOC, right? That is VOC. Therefore, this is VOC. We have to get ISC. Therefore, from these two, ISC is nothing but VOC by RN. VOC is nothing but what? 96 by RN is what? 24, which is equals to 4 amps. So, 4 and 24, option B is correct. So, like this, you have to do the problem. To get, we have what? VTH, RTH, ISC, RN. To get any one of this, this is, for example, this is unknown. But if you know the values of ISC and RTH, that's RTH into ISC, we have VTH. For example, ISC is unknown. If we have VTH and RN, so VTH by RN, ISC is there. If we have VTH and ISC, unknown is RTH. Simple, RTH is what? VTH by ISC, that's it.